And she says, like, my baby's not going to have a unibrow. And the mom just goes, like, pulls up, the little girl goes, ow. And then that was pretty much it. And then the mom said something like, you're not going to have that Garcia brow or something like that.
I'm guessing that's their last name.
Yeah.
Okay.
Many people in the comments had the same opinion I had, which is just like, I get it.
On a three-year-old?
Yes.
A three-year-old?
Yes.
You think it's fine?
I think it's absolutely fine. Shaping her eyebrows, I would think that was a bit much. But to wax in the middle like that, starting so young, probably will reduce the how much hair will grow there. But she's also trying to make sure that, like, her kid doesn't get bullied.
Well, three. I mean, how much bullying is going to be happening?
Okay, so at what age do you start then?
Not three. That's my opinion. But here's the thing. I don't know anything about waxing for the most part. But Elena, you do. You are an anesthetician, right?
I am.
If I'm saying that word right.
It's just esthetician, not anesthetician.
An anesthetician. So, as a cosmetologist. Okay. What is your opinion about waxing a three-year-old's unibrow? And by the way, you can call us at 909-1065 just like Elena did.
Okay, so here's a couple things that I have to say about that situation. One, when you are so young like that, your skin is very vulnerable to bullying. And what that means is the skin outer layer that you see can come off. If the wax is too hot, if they don't use the right wax, if they don't prep the skin properly. So that's a little bit of a risk for me. It's dangerous. As far as the hair growing back faster to Katie's comment, that is possible, but she's so young getting her brows waxed that when she hits hormones, it's going to a bunch of hair.
Oh, sure. It's not going to keep it, like, smooth forever. I want to say, like, just for your reference, it looked like mom was using, like, the Sally Hansen wax strips.
Yeah, I would say no for a Sally Hansen wax strips. Like, are they the sticky, clear, tape-looking?
Yes.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
Somebody texted us. Said, I just started using the eyebrow razor on my 11-year-old. I think that is fine. 11 is the age where, like, you should care about what you look like. And you didn't. Bullying does start to happen. It's a little bit easier. You've done it on my earlobes, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but it comes back so quickly. And if you have dark hair, that's going to start showing right away. How come we're fine, though, with little babies getting their ears pierced?
We've talked about it on the show. I'm not fine with that. I think it's really... It's like when you see a baby who learns to walk before they're one, and they look like a house elf walking into the room.
I mean, I have to say, if my... one of my daughters, I won't say which one, she takes after her father in the hair department, and she is a little on the hairier side. And I have already started cleaning up under her eyebrows so that this becomes part of her life, so that she recognizes that this is, I mean, why do we comb our kids' hair then?
Because it doesn't hurt.
About their parents.
Because it doesn't really hurt them.
But it doesn't, well, it hurts. Yes, it does.
I mean, it can hurt.
If
you do it right. But waxing is unnecessary and painful.
Brushing their hair is, too. It's unnecessary.
Well, I guess it is.
But we do it so that they don't look unsightly,
right? If you are saying that brushing your hair is the same as putting hot wax on a person's face.
She didn't put hot wax on her.
Then how does she do it?
There are these sticky strips. It's not hot wax.
It's just like an adhesive kind of a thing?
Yeah, it's just this, you open it up, you warm it with your hands,
yeah.
And you stick it on your face, and you just pull off.
I guess it's a little bit better, but
it's not
the same thing as brushing your hair.
Does it hurt more? I kind of think when it comes down to it, it is, because it's also that your child doesn't look unkempt.
I don't know. I think that we are starting kids off so early and early and early.
You said you would let your 10-year-old dye their hair.
Because that's their choice. If he wants to dye his hair, I wouldn't dye his hair. I wouldn't make the choice. Why are we shoving kids into being so cognitive of their appearance and caring so much about other people's opinions
because that is real life.
A three-year-old should not care about that. If anybody judges a three-year-old for having a unibrow, shame on you too.
I think it's more just starting it as just a part of what has to be done in your life.
Potty training is that. Not waxing a unibrow. That's my opinion. Elena, go ahead.
If they're still wearing diapers, we're not waxing eyebrows.
She was like 3 and a half. I would say she... You know what? I don't know. My 3.5-year-olds didn't wear diapers, but...
There's somebody who texted in that maybe this is just a happy medium we can all agree on. Or at the very least, TikTok.
Well, at the very least, don't put it on TikTok.
Oh, my God. Coming up, we've got a second date update. Can having a type of girl make you a jerk? Because that's what we're dealing with on this second date update. He is a type. It's not her. And she's pissed about it. You're not going to want to miss the drama. And it's coming up right after One Republic on the Wake Up Call. This first date?
We actually met on Hinge, and then after talking a little bit, we met up, and I thought we had a great time. Like, we both want the same things in life. We had a lot in common, and I honestly didn't think for 1 minute that there wouldn't be a second date, but then afterward, I just never heard from him again, and I don't really understand why, but I'm too nervous to just come out and ask him.
Did you try to reach out to him at all, or just the fact that he...
I texted him, like, the next day, but I don't like to be too thirsty. I don't know. He never texted again, so I was like, what's going on?
Well, we have Greg on hold. Oh, I'm going to put you on hold. You'll be able to hear everything, but we won't be able to hear you. So we're going to talk to Greg and get his answer, and then we'll conference you both together, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Second date update. Olivia is now on hold. Greg, good morning. How are you?
Hey.
Ryan and Katie from The Wake Up Call.